Well, the situation in Syria has been moving so fast, it's really caught many people off guard.
Many of you have had questions as basic as, where is that country exactly and why it's so important? KCRA3's David Bienick joins us now with some answers on Syria. David?
Yeah, let's begin with a little geography. You know where Syria is. It's in the Middle East. But did you know exactly where? It has Turkey up to the north here. Iraq is off to the east. And down south, there's Jordan, Lebanon, and Israel are all of its neighbors. Now, if you're thinking oil is the big factor in this potential airstrike, you're wrong. Syria accounts for less than 1% of the world's total output for oil. Its population and its size are about half as big as California's.
Next, who is Bashar Assad? 48 years old, he's the son of Hafez Assad, who took control of Syria in 1970. Bashar Assad never planned to go into politics and, in fact, was studying in England to become an eye doctor when his older brother died in a car crash. Assad took power in 2000. He's part of a religious minority known as the Alawites. They are Muslims, but are far outnumbered in Syria by Sunni Muslims. What's the Syrian civil war all about? Since the Arab Spring of 2011, Assad has been fighting against a rebel uprising. The rebels include Sunnis, who are tired of Alawite rule, Islamists who want a more religious form of government, and others who want freedom and democracy. If Assad is overthrown, it's not clear who would take over, and the various rebel groups could simply start fighting each other. Why this red line on chemical weapons? True, most of the 100,000 victims in Syria have been killed with old-fashioned bullets and bombs, but the U.S. says it has proof that on August 21st, Assad used sarin gas to kill 1,400 people, including 400 children. Sarin is a nerve gas that causes convulsions, lung failure, and death. It's been banned by the Geneva Convention since 1925, but Syria has never signed on to that treaty. The Obama administration says doing nothing will encourage Syria and other countries to use more chemical weapons in the future.
Finally, a lot of people have asked, why isn't the UN taking the lead on this? Well, the United Nations has sent in these weapons inspectors to confirm whether or not chemical weapons are indeed being used and by whom. But the UN Security Council, which is key, is unlikely to take any action because, as you know, Syria has a key ally on the Security Council in the form of Russia.
Right. Yeah, one of its foreign bases is still there in Syria.
Russia has a base there, yes.
So with that in mind, I mean, what could the U.S. just go at it alone?
It's a possibility. At this point, France is the only country to have signed on if the U.S. decides to go forward. That's only if the U.S. takes the lead.
Things are developing as we speak. David, thanks for that update.